Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's video is a side braid. The French braid version of this style is really popular, so I thought it would be fun to share an elastic version. This is a little bit easier in my opinion, but let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you're new, click that subscribe button and click that little bell, then you'll be notified every time I post a new video. And let's get started.
For this hairstyle, I'm placing my braid on the left side of my head. So I'm going to have my hair parted on the right side, so I have most of the hair to work with on the left side. I'm going to first divide off a section of hair that I'll leave out to frame my face. Then I'm going to pick up a section of hair next to the hairline, brush through it to use for the first section of my braid. And for each section, I'm going to have two separate pieces. So once this piece is divided out, I'm going to pick up another section a few inches back from the hairline from along the part, and I'm going to combine these two sections together. Using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two sections together a few inches down from the part line. I want the top of the braid to be softer, so I'm not placing the first section right on top of my head, but instead a little bit lower. Once it's tied off, I can gently pull on small pieces of hair above the elastic. These will kind of slip out of the elastic, and this will add some volume and create a fuller section. Now I'm going to create a new section of the braid. So I'm dividing off two new pieces of hair on either side of the previous section. The forward section will be from along the hairline, and the back section will be from the top of my head behind the first section that I already tied off. I'm going to combine the two sections together on top of the previously tied off section. Then, using another clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two sections together about an inch or so down from the previous elastic. After it's tied off, I'm going to gently pull on the two sections just above the elastic band so the hair slips out a tiny bit, and this will make it a little puffier and fuller. Now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair for the next part of the braid. So I'm separating off a small section from along the hairline underneath the previously divided off section. Then I'm taking a section from the top of my head behind the previous section, and I'm going to combine the two pieces together over the top of the previously tied off section. I'm going to use another clear elastic band to tie them together and then go back over the hair and carefully puff them up just by gently sliding small sections up and out of the elastic band. Now I'm going to pick up two new pieces for the next section of the braid. So I'm dividing off a section from above my ear and another section from the top of my head. I'm combining them together over the previous section and then tying them off using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going back over the two sides and gently pinching and pulling on small sections of hair, carefully sliding them up and out of the elastic so the two sections are puffier and fuller. Then I'm going back over the two sides and carefully pinching and pulling small sections of hair so they slide out of the elastic so the two side sections are puffier and fuller. I'm going to repeat this process, working my way down the left side of my head, dividing off two sections of hair, one from the front side of the braid and one from the back side of the braid, from along the hairline and from the top or back of my head. And I'm combining them together over the previous section each time and then tying them off using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to puff them up by gently pulling small sections out of the elastic band. And when I'm bringing in hair from the opposite side of my head, so from the right side on the other side, I like to work my way along the part line first, bringing in sections from the very top of my head. And then once it reaches the crown, I'm going to start bringing in sections from the right side and kind of work my way from the top of my head down towards my ear and then the nape of my neck. And I'm going to drape these sections around the back of my head so the back side of the hairstyle looks soft and it creates a side-swept effect. And as the braid gets lower on my head and curves over my shoulder, the hair from the right side of my head will sweep around my head in the direction of my left shoulder and then be combined into the braid. Using elastic bands for each section will help ensure the style stays nice and secured throughout the day. There's less chance the style will slip out or become undone as long as the elastic bands hold. I think this is a really fun alternative to the French braid. I've seen this done with different braids, but using elastic bands is just a little bit easier. It still looks just as cool, but there's no need to know how to braid or braiding involved. Once I've brought in all of the hair from my head, I found that I had three separate sections or ponytails of the braid that's left hanging down. So using the very bottom or lowest section, I'm going to split the hair into two equal sections and then wrap them over the top of the rest of the hair. So I'm continuing the same pattern or style of wrapping the hair on top of the previous section. And then once it's at the top or the front side of the braid, I'm going to tie them together using a new elastic band and continue creating the elastic sections of the braid. I also continued to puff out each section by gently pulling on the hair to loosen them out of the elastic. You can pull the sections a lot and make them really big and full, or keep them smaller depending on the look that you're trying to achieve. I kept mine relatively uniform, not too big, not too small. I did find that the bigger I made them, the kind of messier the style got. So if you want your style to be more casual and soft, you can pull them out a lot. If you want it to be more tight and concise, then you can pull them out less or not pull them out at all. And I created about 5 or 6 sections of the braid draping over my left shoulder. I wanted to go down as far as I could as long as each section was maintaining the same size as the rest of the sections. So once they got to be too small or thin, I stopped splitting the hair and tying new sections of the braid. After I tied off the last section of the braid, I decided I wanted to hide this last elastic band. You could hide each one if you wanted, but I decided not to do that. So to hide the bottom elastic, I took my topsy-tail tool, and I found this on Amazon, and I pushed the end of the tool inside or through the elastic so the loop was at the top and the tail was poking out the bottom. Then I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the ponytail, and I wrapped it a couple of times around the elastic. Then I pulled the end of the wrapped piece through the tool, through the loop at the top. And then I'm going to pull the tail of the tool down so the top loop is squeezed through the elastic band. And this will pull the end of that wrapped piece through the elastic, and that is what will hold it in place without needing to use another elastic or a bobby pin. I think this style is so cool because it looks just like a side braid, but there's no braiding involved, and because each section is tied off with an elastic, it's a lot more secure and should hold throughout the day.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Comment down below what you think about this hairstyle. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you're new, please subscribe, click that notification bell, then you'll never miss any future uploads, and I will see you next time.